Just in time for What's Hot, this is where we talk about those stories that have everybody talking.
Today we're joined by John Ann Willow, a freelance writer and editor from Milwaukee Magazine and the Biz Times. Plus, Tracy Johnson is back.
I'm outnumbered again.
Yeah, always. If a shooter came to your job or school, would you know what to do? Experts are doing everything they can to teach everyday citizens survival skills. Active shooter drills are being done across the country. So should drills be a requirement at all businesses and schools?
They do it at schools already here in Wisconsin. I mean, that's the law. You've got to practice this stuff.
Yep.
What about your workplace?
Well, just like a tornado drill, which is something that we practice in our building, I think that we're to a point, and not that the prevalence of shooters is at that point, but I think our society is ready to say we want to take a more active role and we want to know what to do, because what they're saying is that hiding underneath a desk or hiding underneath a chair is not going to do it. You need to take an active role, and we want to inform you. I think it should be the law.
I don't know if I agree with that. I don't know about making it the law. You know, the thing is someone on my Facebook page today had a great point about it, and that is you really do need to train a lot of people, because it's very natural to want to panic. So if a lot of people are trained, it really only takes one person taking the right actions, barring the door, calling the police, and getting into quick action. So in that case, I can see, you know, encouraging a lot of training, but I have some pretty deep-seated reservations about the state that we've become when we feel like we have to actually mandate that people take anti-victimization training.
Well, and I would normally agree, because the more laws drive me crazy. But here's the deal. If something like this happens in my workplace, gosh, I'm going to be really glad that law exists. And frankly, I think a lot of people would benefit from you know, being in that state of panic and trying to say, how do I calm myself and how do I really handle this situation?
It may be helpful at a minimum for employers to tell you, here are safe places in the building you can go to and get outside if something should happen.
I actually like that approach much better than mandating by law that people be trained to not get shot.
Well, and they're talking about how do you get out. They're changing the way of thinking from hiding to getting out.
So okay. And that could backfire too. Think about that.
All right. Coming up next, we reveal the viewer's choice topic of the day.
And Michael Fish, viewer's choice topic of the day.
Again, we're joined by John Ann Willow and Tracy Johnson from the Commercial Association of Realtors. Today's viewer's choice topic, community leaders calling on thousands of people to gather tomorrow in Milwaukee to march against violence. They're calling for a 10,000-man march, recognizing the anniversary of the Million Man March. Will this make a difference in the fight against violence?
Violence is really not well defined in the event giver's overview here. There's all kinds of violence in the city. Some of it is perpetrated by police, which I believe is the implication for this march. Dontre Hamilton, if he did need to be shot in the park in the middle of the day, probably did not need to be shot 14 times at point blank range. However, violence in the city is not caused by police or by police using excessive force. So I'm really not very clear on exactly how this march is supposed to get. I'm not sure what the agenda is.
Well, I think by 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon we'll have our answer. Was this done in the spirit really of peaceful protest? I mean, you know, getting attention, I think, is what we need to do, and getting people engaged in the activity that will get them off the street. So, you know, I have no problem with that. But if they're blocking freeways, or if they're, you know, shouting against police brutality, or not in the spirit of what its intentions are, then I think that's a problem.
What do you think would make more of a difference? I mean, if they really want this march to be anti-violence, coming downtown and marching and blocking traffic, or going into the neighborhoods mm-hmm. that have the gang problems and going after the violence there. I mean, that was caused 80-some homicides in the city of Milwaukee this year.
I think those are two separate actions, and I think both of them are really important. So if we send 1,000 people downtown with a clearly defined agenda and we have an open dialogue and it's very peaceful, that really does, of course, help to raise the profile of it. I'm assuming that there are similar marches around the country. This is not the only city with a violence issue. But getting into those neighborhoods is really, really important. Until we crack that nut where neighborhoods are willing to work to affect change, as a community, I don't know what the solution is.
And they are starting the march over at the Black Holocaust Museum, as far as I know. So maybe that's a start. But yeah, I think when the news footage shows 1,000 people blocking traffic, even if it is peaceful, I'm sorry, but that sends the wrong message. So, you know, we'll see how it ends.
All right, we have to end there. It's time for our lightning round. The Who are playing in Milwaukee next year for their 50th anniversary. The only two original members of the band will be over 70 years old, and both now need backup artists to fill out some of their guitar and voice work. So, question is this show going to be worth seeing? What do you guys think?
The last time I saw The Who was in 1987. Roger Daltrey was half deaf, and Pete Townsend was almost all the way deaf. In fact, he had to stand behind a plexiglass wall so that so his tinnitus didn't send him to his knees. I don't imagine it's gotten better in 30 years, just saying. While I would like to support them, because Pete Townsend says, we'll tour until people stop buying tickets, I kind of wonder if this might be the time to say, hey guys, let's stop buying tickets.
Well, you know, and part of the concert is what's going on stage. And frankly, if they were up there and they lip synced, I think it would be better than lots of concerts that I've seen where people have lip synced, right?
That's because you like, well, you know.
We talked about this earlier.
I'm like, you're a pop queen. You're a pop queen.
You know, but at the end of the day, I liken it to a Jimmy Buffett concert, right? I got to do a Jeff reference here. You're not there necessarily to see what's on stage. You're there because of the people that are there.
For the show.
Yeah.
So there'll be a lot of, all the handicapped spaces will be taken up. There'll be a long line at the handicapped stall in the bathroom.
It'll be fun. I bet it'll be a sellout.
Oh, let me know how it is, okay?
I will not be there.
Maybe you and Jeff can go.
John Ann, you'd show up, you'd be a young punk at that concert.
I really would. Oh, that's a great reason to go.
All right, hey, I'm gonna edit myself here. The homicide rate, not 80-something, we're at 70 for the year in the city of Milwaukee.
I want to
make sure the right number gets out there. The What's Hot discussion will continue online. Find it at tmj4.com/